John and Bob here from Lake Tahoe Adventures. Good to see you in here. Bob, nice to see you in here. I know you're the lead guide, head guide. For how long? A long time, huh?
Oh, 14 years.
Damn. Man, that's a long time.
Years, yes.
And we were talking during the break. It's crazy. I mean, it's skiing, it's snowmobiling. When you talk to people that haven't been out, they're oblivious.
They have no idea.
Because in town, I mean, you've been here a long time. We all have been. Yeah. It is crazy. In town, it's like almost bone dry, and yet above 8,000 feet, it's fantastic.
Even above 7,000.
Even above, okay.
The bad thing is it's been that way almost all winter, so it's very deceiving. And, you know, if you go up to the ski resorts, if you go up to Sierra or Kirkwood or Heavenly, you're going to see the same thing. You're going to be absolutely astounded, which is kind of a cool thing because it certainly exceeds your expectations when you get there, as well as with us. Yeah. You know, the ride up, you're going, oh, great.
Totally. Mm-hmm.
And then all of a sudden you get there on the snowmobile, you're going, dang.
Yeah.
This really is winter. There really is snow up here. They weren't kidding.
Yeah. So how many tours you guys take out this time of year? Does it slow down a little bit now?
It slows down a little bit. We've been averaging 3-4 tours a day, though.
Uh-huh.
We're still staying pretty busy.
Good. And I snowmobile as well. I know you're an avid snowmobiler. Like, what would you call conditions? What would you say conditions are like?
Right now, if you're out there where the snow's at, it's excellent conditions. It's fantastic out there. The little snow we did get was really light, fluffy snow.
Yeah, it was good. Really it was kind of like the right amount of moisture.
What would you say our foundational base is up on the summit?
Up on the summit, I was looking at the signs and depth of the signs.
Right.
So that's a good 5 foot.
Uh-huh, in areas. The forecast is even more promising, like not just through the weekend, but even into next week long term, at least the forecast anyway.
And we're talking yesterday at 8,000 feet, 5 feet of snow. Cat that groomed yesterday reported we got 1.5 feet on top of that with drifts waist deep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because we had 80 mile an hour winds up there.
Yeah.
So you're talking about a really decent winter season going on up there right now in darn near April, which is really cool for this year. So it's not dead yet.
And I keep saying, I'm hoping that this is the season that never really would begin, but then wouldn't end. Because the forecast, I mean, we've all been here. I mean, how many times have you been all the way through April? And through May with storms, it can happen, man.
Well, they're saying look out now for the week of April 7th, right?
The long term is really good. The other thing that you guys do, and I guess you're a lead guide as well down in the desert?
Yes.
Yeah, and you've added to the fleet. You're kind of switching around what you take out in the desert, aren't you?
We're increasing the Razors, the car type vehicles that you actually drive. They're easier for people. You can take the littler kids with you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of people have a license or have driven cars before that haven't driven handlebar vehicles. And so we're increasing the amount of the vehicles that we have, even considering doing some things with the cars on the Rubicon.
I mean, because I guess the video we're looking at, those are all just the four-wheelers, right?
Like, correct.
I don't know that we have any video of the Razors.
We do. There should be some on here.
Okay,
I know
so maybe there's a little bit on there. But
you might see some go by.
They're relatively new on the market. I think there's a lot of people haven't seen them. I was just telling you, I got to drive one down in the valley just a couple of weeks ago. And
they're amazing vehicles. They've taken off like wildfire. You're inside a roll cage. You're driving with a steering wheel, a gas pedal, and a brake. You're strapped in.
Yep.
They're pretty darn safe. They're comfortable to be in. They're convenient to operate.
They're powerful, man. They can climb. and they're smooth over stuff.
Yeah.
So you're doing those tours as well right now in the desert?
Yeah, I was in the desert just 4 days ago.
Really?
Yeah.
So those are more spread out like every few days, and then you're going daily for snowmobiling still?
Correct, yeah.
Bob never knows what hat to wear when he's out of bed.
I've gone out on a snowmobiling tour one day and did the snowmobile tour, and then they say, okay, now you're going down the desert.
Same day. Yeah.
That's awesome. That's great.
Bob does all our extreme stuff. Any of the real intricate, deep tours, the Rubicon Springs tour that goes all the way down in, or the very extreme ultimate tours that are off trail of mountains way up into Lost Lakes area and things like that. Mm-hmm. He's the man for the job. So.
Well, that's awesome. I'm just glad to hear that snowmobiling's been as good. I mean, you guys have been kind of, you know, with all due respect to the other operations, kind of the only thing going on. Because your location
we feel for the other guys. We opened up on December 5th this year, and we haven't closed a day since.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people still don't know that. They think Tahoe is kind of shut down going into summertime.
I know.
And that's kind of unfortunate. But that said, this is a great time to be having fun in Tahoe. You got the place to yourselves. The ski resorts are all rocking. There's great snow, great conditions. It's
as good as it gets right now.
And it's easy traveling around, right?
Yeah. You can drive. Yeah. You know, it's easy. I mean, everybody's taking like their snow tires off and their studded tires off.
Right.
So I mean,
well, if you talk to locals who've been around here for a while, what does everybody say?
Yeah.
It's March, man.
Don't
write it off yet.
Yeah, don't take the tires off yet. I'm with you. Well, good to see you guys both in here, Lake Tahoe Adventures, either into the desert, up into Hope Valley for snowmobiling. Give them a call and get out on a tour. We'll be right back.